Hello folks, this is Bob, back in a week. It will not be an understatement to say that Indian foreign policy is in turmoil. I don't say in a flux, I'd say in turmoil. I think we've bitten off more than we can chew. And it's been driven, a lot of the agenda is being driven by domestic politics both here and in Canada. The nationalism that is prevalent in India shows that all the headlines are being managed to say that we've taken on Canada, we've done this, we've done that. But what comes through is, in my opinion, a complex, a colonial complex that always considers the West to be the bad boy. You're playing with these guys. There's upwards of a few billion dollars, $30 billion, I'm told, invested in Indian startups and stock market by Canadian pension funds and so on and so forth. You have a huge diaspora in the United States, United States and North America and Canada that you're playing with. Right? But hey, you know how things go from, I like if they say, could they be worse? Probably not. Things, you know, we were coming off a glory, like I said, at G20 summit, a scramble for India, it sure was. Then you had C. Raja Mohan Rai, Delhi is raising the game, it recognizes the intersection of great power rivalry with regional geopolitics needs continuous tending. He says, Delhi now takes an integrated view of its interests and pursues them through new cross-cutting forums. As Jaishankar told the Southeast Asian leaders in Jakarta last week, the Quad is complementary to the efforts of the ASEAN and the institutions led by it. As India becomes a major economic entity with significant geopolitical heft, its ability to shape the intersection between its extended neighborhood and the world will rapidly grow. The only part I disagree essentially with is a geopolitical heft, its ability to shape, is its economy. It's actually not growing. And when you see Ram Madhav has his foreign policy knowledge could be on a pinhead, right? But this is the attitude that is not good for anybody. Ball is in Canada's court. Trudeau has ignored India's concern and allowed extremist activities to flourish in Canada, which might be true. But if you can see the statements now that are changing from coming out from the United States, you could almost see earlier, none of these guys were really out there supporting the Canadian version. Though the way they came out, they knew there was something in it, right? But the statements that came out on the 22nd and how they've played out on the front pages of Global Mail in Canada suggest that the US is taking this a lot more seriously, because that means that the proof provided by Canada is quite substantive as it's being played out in the Canadian broadcasting, right? Trudeau's remark attempt to shift focus from China links through this. This is even the Canadian commentators and editorials were saying the same thing, that Trudeau must come out with a proof before making allegations like this, because India is just too important a partner for all its countries, whether it is all its allies, which is the United States, Australia, New Zealand, UK. India is just too important for them to trash us, right? And more likely than not, it'll be the Ministry of Defense, Department of Defense, that will take precedence over the Secretary of State. But things might change if the proof out there is hardcore. India asks for proof briefs, allies on Ottawa's attitude. India cautions its citizens in Canada on political condoned hate crime. And this is kind of extreme from India. Human and signal intel on India, Canada government sources tell media. Now, this is headline in Times of India today. So this is the reality, because then you see this. Biden spoke to Modi about Niger at G20, okay? No special exemption for actions like this, says US NSA today. Canada says no place for hate, reassures Hindus. The game for Ram Madhav, unfortunately, when he is forced to come out with an editorial, is that this, let me just say this, you clap on both sides. Khalistan, Canadistan is a reality in Canada. But what is also a reality is, why is it now on a boil, right? Last 9 years, it's on a boil. Why is that? Because Punjab politics between Sikhs and the right-wing RSS are beginning to play out overseas. You watch my words. So here's how it's raining on our parade. US President invited for Republic Day parade. And boy, this was like, oh, just the day this news came out, they did this. But Sullivan refuses to confirm Biden's Republic Day trip, and that's today. Canada NSA met Doval before during Trudeau trip to Delhi. USA is in touch with both governments. That is again today, right? In touch with India and Canada, US NSA, Canada attempts to win support from Five Eyes, and I think it's working on it. G7 chair, Japan refuses support to Canada. And you know, this is the Panjin John. Now he's playing the government, son, but that's not true. They are waiting their time. Like I said, the Ministry of Defense Strategic Affairs is probably currently holding fort because India is, as far as they are concerned, very critical for India. But like I'll tell you, how things can go wrong if you overplay your hand, right? Eye on China, Quad commits to a free, open and inclusive Indo-Pacific. India extends sea legs further in Indian Ocean. Reiterate commitment to Indo-Pacific. EAM shares views on Canada with Japan, Australia. Just remember this. India's importance to every article, whether German papers, French papers, Canadian papers, British papers, US papers, Australian papers. The fine line is India's importance is one because of its democracy, which now everybody is worried about, but more importantly about China. And that's it, folks. That's it. You know, we've been there forever. If we were that critical, we would have been in place since our independence, right? Corridor to a new world. So there's Biden, right? He takes off from Vietnam. He's done a great job. Just remember, now I'm going to play this out, why I think we can't overplay this, right? Biden goes from here to Vietnam. Why Vietnam? Vietnam's fought a war with China and is standing up to China, right? Because of South China Sea. For Biden, he remembers World War II and all his strategic community. What happened in Pearl Harbor? Threat is the Pacific. So when you look at the Pacific, right, and you can see this expanse on the Pacific, that's America's backyard. The front yard is Russia. NATO has been strengthened to take that on. So it's something that Biden is now saying that, okay, he's supplying arms to Ukraine, and all the guys in NATO, including the guys who are waiting to join, are fully militarily trained with equipment from the United States. So Russia is, and Russia is now a depleted military force, right? So his worry is the Pacific because of Taiwan. So his core interest, folks, is, and you remember this, his core interest, if I was a security advisor in the United States, India would be there, yes. But my core interest would be Japan, frontline state, Korea, frontline state, Taiwan, frontline state, Australia, frontline state, and my allies would be Vietnam, Philippines, and Indonesia. These, to me, are far more critical in controlling China than India is. Far more critical for the United States. Just do remember that when you try and play these cards, right? And he's thinking, so here's what he's done. He's got Vietnam on his side. Now he's also played, this was his biggest play, right? Corridor to a new world. IMEC has immense potential to put India, Middle East and Europe on collective path to growth, triggering regional and global cooperation. IMEC is India's movement, but it will also be cornerstone of economic progress across the region by supercharging regional trade and connecting Asia with Europe through a region that has never since the ancient Red Sea route seen considered for such connectivity, despite its game-changing potential in terms of shorter transits, accessibility and multimodal connectivity. Okay, this is a great thing, but if anybody saw what happened day before in our parliament and the words used against Danish Ali by Bhaduri, you will know, and that video is playing out across the Middle East. Across the Middle East. How do we expect this to come true? You tell me, right? And the United States did it for this. At UN, China poses as leader of Global South, challenging the West. Why the US propped India up, didn't bring up Canada and Niger's killing in G20? Because they wanted India to be crowned the global leader of the South, but like India always does, India again cut its own feet, right? So this is all what the US is doing to make sure this is a reality. BB and MBS make a play for Middle East peace. US-Bahrain pact seen as model for work in Persian Gulf. US and Saudi explore a mutual defense treaty. Biden and Netanyahu emphasize US-Israeli unity on curbing Iran. So the US is doing its bit to bring the entire piece together, whether it's Middle East now. So look at Middle East, right? Khashoggi, how many people remember it? The pressure on Biden from its liberal right and left ensured that Saudi Arabia stayed in the cold for at least the last 3 years because of the killing of Khashoggi, American citizen in Turkey, right? Now, this is exactly, Niger is exactly that. He could be anybody, right? He could be a criminal, he could be a terrorist, he could be a drug lord. But to go and do this on Canadian soil, and there may be some truth, if there is truth in it, then I don't think anybody's going to stand for this, right? And eventually, 3 years for India, especially in the precarious economic situation that we are, is not good news. And Biden was really happy, right? He's got Vietnam on his side. He's got India propped up as a leader of the South. He's now got, he's now essentially got MBS on his side. That was what India bridged that gap. And China was being hammered all across every newspaper, right? EU demands China action on trade barriers. US business confidence in China dropped to 24-year low. China's economy faces even bigger housing crisis. Russian banks propped up by Chinese cash after transactions. And as Sahil Rav Das Gupta writes, Emperor's new clothes. He writes, the Chinese president does not want to be seen in New Delhi because that would amount to endorsing India's global leadership, which has become a major challenge for Beijing. She is conscious that the US is encouraging India to take up a global leadership role, even participate in distant issues like South China Sea as a means to contain China's influence. So the US has managed to do that, right? After Beijing talks, US rejects Chinese appeal to ease tech exports. Africa pushes back against China's predatory practices in rare earth mineral sector. China shows sign of decoupling from US as FDI and trade decline. US lenders in China are no longer immune to geopolitical rivalries. Anecdotal accounts suggest Western banks in China, though not yet the subject of open hostility, may soon become so. And that will be the last nail on the West's fascination with China, right? China uses AI to spread disinformation about Maui wildfires. China property revival plan hit by residential backlash. China steps up show of force around Taiwan. And like I said, Taiwan is the more critical component for the United States, not India, right? EU launches probe of subsidies of China's electric vehicle makers. EU launches subsidy probe into Chinese electric cars. Every newspaper. EU tries to buy time in China electric car race. China tries to headhunt Britons in sensitive jobs. That means they don't have intelligent people there, right? Including pilots, including armed forces, right? Foreign capital flees China biotech. China saw Fiji as a template for the Pacific. It wasn't. Chinese diplomats say MP meddling, not Beijing. So here we have China's democracy equation written by Ashutosh Vasani. Is there a non-electoral way of imagining democracy for China's social scientists and intellectual challenge ahead? He says democracy has become a great currency of international respect in modern times. Just remember this, great respect, right? That's why India was where it was. That is why dictatorships of the proletariat, a celebratory Marxist concept of the past, has disappeared from the leftist political lexicon. Even under Xi, China uses the term social democracy to describe what the polity and society are all about. Though sometimes challenged, the legitimacy of democracy as one of the highest political ideals has not been undermined. So this is for India to note, and we really can't affect to do that. Mobs on rampage in parts of Imphal and say we are a democracy. And what it did in Canada, this is how it's playing out. The United States comes out and says, US urges India to help investigate killing of Sikh leader. Now, US is getting very aggressive. Row not to impact Canada's presence in army chief meet. Like I said, the army and the military forces will still hold fort. Ottawa calls for calm after India issues travel advisory. India spy agency drawn out of the shadows. India demands cuts in Canada's embassy citing diplomatic interference. Now, this is overreaction. Ottawa has done the unthinkable by uniting India's political parties. Tension raised concerns. Fewer Indians will now opt to study. That means fewer option for Indians. New Delhi suspension of Canadian visas puts travel plans on hold. Again, an overreaction. India suspends visa for Canadians. That I think is the stupidest mistake they've made. India warns of hate crimes in Canada as tension mounts. I don't expect that to happen. Canadian Sikhs hail Trudeau for vocalizing cause against India. Well, like I said, Canada's allegation further divide India's diaspora. Trudeau claims Indian government linked to Khalistan leaders killing. Delhi says absurd. Canada's evidence and its Five Eye Alliance frame India's challenge. This is what's happened, right? Australia-US voiced deep concern on Trudeau's claim of India's killing. Envoy expulsion departure from norm. Trudeau triggers diplomatic firestorm with Indian remark. Hate crimes, violence in Canada saves India's travel advisory. Again, an overblown expression, right? Then what do you have? Then you have India suspends visa services, calls Canada terror safe haven. That was stretching it a bit, but I guess that's payback time. India bars visa services for Canadians as tensions rise. India suspends visa issuance in Canada. NIA seeks info on 10 accused in San Francisco. India suspends visa for Canadians, asks Ottawa to downsize mission. Trudeau ducks queries on lack of evidence, international support. Trudeau part MP takes on Khalistan camp. Don't pack bags yet, plan session for next fall, Canada University to students. US Australia lend support to Canada, call for India's cooperation in probe, right? Amid chill in India, Canada ties, agencies working to tackle nexus of separatists. Canada and India trade diplomatic expulsions over assassination row. Trudeau brings Sikh separatism cause to the fore with assassination claim. Then what do you have? India blasts Canada over Trudeau's allegation on killing. West demands answers on Sikh assassination, right? Tension between China, Canada and India has Biden in tight spot. He does. Biden, then he says, exit cannot be trusted. Canada, India trade diplomatic expulsions. After Canada's murder claim, tension with India boils. Canada-Indian tensions boil after murder claim. Trudeau accuses India of killing a Sikh leader on Canadian soil. Trudeau accuses India of a Sikh killing. These are newspapers across the globe, folks. That's why I'm reading them out. Canada probes India over killing. But at the end of the day, what is it? As Brahma Chalani rightly puts it, the problem is Canadistan. Under Trudeau, Canada has become Khalistani extremism's global hub. He cannot cite free speech to defend inaction. Ottawa has laws against incitement to violence. Why aren't they used? Indian diplomacy must also exert sustained pressure on the other Anglosphere countries to stop countenancing the rising anti-India activity of extremists, Khalistani groups operating on their territories. That may be true, folks. We need to do that. But we need to provide proof. And I know it. We don't provide any proof. We accuse and no proof is given ever after that. Three cheers and Jai Hind.